What is up, Terabytes? It's me, Tara, with Tara Simon Studios, and today is a very cringe-worthy video for me. You guys have been asking for so long, and I have been avoiding it for so long, and I'm finally giving you me reacting to me on X Factor. Dun dun dun. So, here we go. I haven't watched this in years.
Good looking, bad tasting, full bodied, butt wasted.
It's originality that's got me here, and it's originality that would keep me here.
Look at me.
If you're a good singer, you should shine wherever you get a spot. I'm gonna find a way.
Can we have Tara Simon, please?
There are so many things I want to say already about this. So first, let me just say this. What I'm going to tell you is my personal experience of what happened behind the scenes. What you see is all you have to go by. So what I'm going to tell you right now before we even start listening to me sing is this. My experience on the X Factor can be summed up in pretty much one example, and this happened to me time and time and time again during filming, which took months, by the way. My very first audition on X Factor that was filmed was in front of LA Reid, Britney Spears, Demi Lovato, and Simon, and you are told to wear the same thing for days because of continuity, and so the same for the judges. And so I went on the stage and I was asked a question by LA Reid, and the question that I was asked is not the same question that you heard aired all over the world for everyone to see. What I was asked was, who would you like to do a duet with most in the music industry? And my answer was Christina Aguilera. And duh, because I love her and she's amazing, and who wouldn't want to do a duet with Christina Aguilera? And so I finished my audition, I got four yeses, and I went through and I left. Well, later that day, LA Reid, in the same suit, asked someone else who they would like to take out of the music industry. So the question was, who would you like to take out of the music industry? So they took his question, looking at the stage to someone, and they spliced it with my answer. And it sounded like this, Tara, which he didn't say, but who do you, directed towards me, or it seemed like that, who do you want to take out of the music industry? And they kept my answer, Christina Aguilera. Enter hate mail and death threats from around the world, from Christina Aguilera fans. I am one of them. So that was fun. And what you're seeing here, so what they would do is they would like film you with like really, you know, from really, really far away. You wouldn't know you were being filmed. They would like slide these mics under your chair. And I would see this going on and I would think, wow, like I need to show people like they're being filmed when they don't know it. And so I was busy like telling people like, hey, they're recording you right now, but I never saw it for myself. And so, you know, you're waiting around for like hours and hours and hours, sometimes 8 hours a day. It's like a hurry up and wait thing in your clothes and you're just doing whatever. So I look like I'm freaking pole dancing there. I'm just bored and I'm hanging out and just, you know, being silly. And they put bad kind of look at me music underneath it. And all of a sudden I'm the villain of the show. So it's so unfair and so crazy, and I'm gonna tell you more stories about it, but let's hear me sing. Jeez.
Hi, Tara.
Anxiety.
How are you guys?
I'm good, thank you. You look great.
Thank you. So do
Simon.
You.
Thank you, I know.
Was very nice to me. He likes brunettes.
Let's do it.
I still have that dress, by the way. Sophie's so sweet. A little pitchy there. I got a little too carried away. Okay, let's stop right there for a second. It's so gross. So Camila Cabello from Fifth Harmony, they hadn't been put together yet. I mean, literally, guys, we were on that stage for 2 days filming everybody, going through everybody's stuff, and cameras on you. You never know what's being filmed, and they have so much footage to go by. Again, you're wearing the same outfit. And Camila, when this aired, she Facebook messaged me and was like, Miss Tara, because everybody called me Miss Tara because the vocal coach thing, I don't know, but she was like, Miss Tara, I didn't make that face when you were singing. I'm so sorry they made it look like that. And I was like, it's okay, honey. I know. It's fine. Same thing with Sophie. Like, Sophie and I were friends, and they made this whole drama about how, like, you know, I dissed Sophie or something, and Sophie actually took to Twitter and was like, it's kind of really not like that. I don't really know what they're saying. Like, Tara and I are friends. So again, like, time after time after time. And actually, this is a very interesting song. So Somebody to Love, it's a very long song, right? And what you see is about, I don't know, 30 seconds of, you know, kind of schizophrenic singing. I was actually the only person on the history of the show to never have been cut off. And I sang the entire song, and I planned that song thinking, okay, at some point someone's gonna cut me off. Like, I don't have to vocally get through this whole song the way I designed it to be, because I designed it to be extremely hard, and I'm gonna get cut off, so it's fine, I don't have to do the whole thing. I didn't get cut off. I sang the whole stinking song, and at any moment in the pauses, I was like, someone cut me off, I'm ready to stop. That's what I was thinking in my head, but I did the whole song, and I was the only person who never got cut off in the history of the show. I was also the only person in the history of the show, which you did not see, to get a standing ovation from the people you see sitting behind me rolling their eyes. That didn't happen when I was singing. That happened throughout the day. I mean, we could have been having conversations and someone make a joke and someone went like that and they used that. That's literally what editing is, and that's what they did. And I'm sorry to blow the spot off of TV shows and reality TV shows, but that's what they do on every single show. I mean, you could be watching Chopped, a food show, and they do it there. Like, why? Why would you do it there? I don't know. That's what they do. Okay? So, again, only person in the history of the show never to have been cut off. You usually get 30 to 60 seconds. They didn't cut me off. And I'm the only person in the history of the show to have gotten a standing ovation from my competitors behind me. And it was actually, I know it's kind of sounded a little crazy in certain parts, but that was one of the best, most fun performances of my life. I had so much fun. And it's so sad to me. It just breaks my heart that they felt the need to just bastardize it and edit it beyond recognition. I mean, they just splice and dice so bad. And of course, you don't know that because you weren't there and you don't see. So it's so easy to create some reality out of this fabricated footage that they see. So let's keep watching, see what else they do.
Oh, it was so fun! I want to do it again.
When you watched that back, fun. You're going to find that you showed us a little bit more than you expected.
Oh,
there.
No.
I'm afraid so. Okay, follow that.
I don't really know what he meant there, but whatever. Okay, so actually, so I'm gonna tell you another thing that really hurt my heart, like, a lot on this show. So one of my friends was Daryl on the show, and he was actually the guy sitting next to me, and we hung out, like, we were close on the show, and you spend a lot of time with these people, you know, and you become friends, and we were tight. We even wrote a song together, and I found out at the end of the show that he was wearing a wire. He was wearing a microphone to try to catch me saying stuff to him in confidence that they could use on the show later on. And I remember he was acting really weird, and I saw something on his shirt, and I was like, what is that? And I moved his shirt over and I saw the wire, and I was like, are you kidding me? Really? Like, you? I was so hurt. I was so hurt. And another thing that really hurt me, aside from my friend with the wire, was that there was a time in the show where producers of the show actually took time out of their day at the end of the day to come to my hotel room and thank me. And I remember what he said. He's like, you know, we just wanted to stop by and say thank you because, you know, you could be a diva and you could be a jerk. You know, you're a formidable competitor. You've got a great voice, but we see you. You know, you had a backpack full of food when, you know, pizza ran out and you were feeding people from your backpack, and there were little girls there who couldn't memorize their lines, and we saw you help them, and we just wanted to thank you for being kind. And I was like, that's so nice. Of course, like, I'm a coach, I can't help myself, like, I have to help. It's ingrained in me, it's my job, you know. And I hope that those weren't the same people in the editing room doing to me what they did. I mean, but I would, I don't know. I'll never know why. When I get to heaven, I'm going to ask God, why did they do that? Like, why wouldn't they just let the people who were mean as they were on the show be the villains of the show? Why do they spend so much time making me look catty and bratty and diva-ish and cray? Like, when that's just simply not what happened. And guys, listen, it's so long ago. If that's the way I was, I would totally own it. I'd be like, hey, you know, I had a lot to learn. I was a brat, blah, blah, blah. But no, like, there's a difference between confidence and cocky, and there is a fine line. And for someone who's animated like me, I can see how easily it could be twisted. But for those of you who are listening to this who care, you have to know, I have nothing to win or lose by setting any record straight. It's been years ago. Nobody freaking cares about X Factor anyway, you know? You wanted me to react to this, and I'm just telling you the honest truth. That's not who I am. Who they made me out to be is not who I am. And one thing that meant the world to me, which is one of the reasons to this day I still coach, is I remember getting out of my car, getting ready to coach my first lesson after that episode aired, like after I started airing on X Factor. And I remember thinking, I'm going to lose my students. People are going to think I'm a terrible person. And I remember getting out of my car, and the mom and the student was waiting for me. And I remember opening my mouth to explain, and she said, stop. She goes, it's going to make me cry. She goes, we don't want you to say a word. We know your character. And we don't care what we saw. We know that that's not who you are. And that it healed everything that had been broken and everything that I had been afraid of, and it made it better. And just to know that the people that knew me knew, and I didn't even need to open my mouth to explain, hey, this was editing, this was this. They just knew based on who they knew I was. And that just ministered so much to me in my heart, and I was so grateful for that. And it was student after student, parent after parent who said that to me. And was just, you really know who your friends are after something like that happens to you. So now I turn lemons into lemonade by having my students on every single one of these shows. Angelica Hale on America's Got Talent, Lauren Lott on American Idol, Victoria McQueen on American Idol, Clara Hong on The Voice. I mean, we've got all the bases covered, and it's now my life's greatest joy to help those who want to be on shows and to be on big platforms do it in a way that's safe, that keeps them from having this happen to them, and has their vocals only showcased, all the good stuff. And now I know what not to do because I know what happened to me. And now that I know how to keep it from happening from others. Yeah, exactly. So I would do it all over again to be able to protect my vocal babies and tell them the pitfalls of what could happen. I'm a lot stronger than I realized, and I was able to get through it and bear the fruits later on for other people. So thank you so much for asking me to react to me. I'm so sick of myself right now. but hopefully you're not. And if you're not, subscribe to the channel, click the notifications button. Make sure you check out the description box below. There's lots of links there to help you take your voice from good to great. Or maybe I sound like a plastic chicken to great. Or maybe I only sing in the shower or in the car to great. Wherever you are in your vocal journey, I want to help you. And those links below will help you do just that. I love you. I'm proud of you. And I'll see you guys on the next one.